Tomorrow, the Tamworth Invitational is on. Now, for some people in Australia, that will be meaningless. For others, it is the best entertainment that money can buy. And for a very select few, it will come down to 8 seconds. Brendon Clark is 31, Lachlan Richardson is 20. They are professional bull riders and they join me now. Morning to you guys.
Morning.
Is it you have to wear the hats?
You don't have to wear a hat, but if you're a cowboy, you usually do wear a hat.
And so that's the thing. I mean, a lot of people will sort of maybe joke about it or something. You guys are cowboys.
Yeah, well, that's what we are. And, you know, every day of our life, we get up and wear a cowboy hat. And that's, you know, that's just the way we choose to live our lifestyle.
The irony is here, Brendon, you're 31. I would imagine, and I don't know, but I would imagine that that's starting to get on for a professional bull rider. It seems to be keeping you young, whereas I would have thought you would be just a horribly disfigured human being by now.
Oh, well, inside I probably am. My body might be worn out, but mentally it's still, you know, I'm still young. And fellas like Lachlan keep me young, keep you honest. You know, I've got to work harder and harder for me now to still make a career out of this, because, you know, these young fellas keep coming through and pushing you every day. So
obviously what you learn, you get huge experience. So you start, I'm imagining, to be able to second guess what the beast is going to do versus the fact that your body is racked. And so you just, I suppose, can't afford so many knocks.
Yeah, I mean, nobody really likes to get hurt, but unfortunately in this sport, it's guaranteed that it's going to happen. And, you know, we've both had our fair share of injuries, and especially me. I mean, I've been around the game, especially at the top level, for a long time, and it's not easy, and that's why not everyone wants to do it.
I wanted to be at Lachlan, a beekeeper, once, and on the first page of the beekeeping manual, it said, if you don't want to be stung, don't keep bees. Is it the same sort of thing? You know, if you don't want to be kicked off a beast and trampled underfoot, don't try and be a bull rider.
Yeah, that's true, because it's going to happen to everyone. No one's ever stayed on every bull they've got on. So it's, yeah, you're going to get hurt, but you can get hurt doing anything.
So you're sitting there, I mean, it's nerve-wracking just to watch it for me. You're sitting there ready for those gates to open. Those last few seconds before the gates open, what's going through your mind?
You don't try to let too much go through your mind. It's, you've done all your preparation up leading up to it, and you've, it's really just reaction. You've got to get on and just, it's what you do for your sport and you love it. So
how much of it comes down to the bull?
Yeah, a lot. Like, the bull's half the score, so if the bull doesn't perform, yeah, you're not going to have a high enough score to be in the money.
You've got a little nick on your face here. Is that a bull riding thing?
Yeah, that was when I first started.
Tell me, oh, really? When you were only just being really badly hurt, what happened there?
A calf kicked me when I was about 11.
When did you start?
10.
And did your parents sort of strap you to a bull and said, this is your career, son, or was it your idea?
No, it was me and my two older brothers wanted to have a go, so we went to a local rodeo and our family supported us, and yeah, we've just kept going from there.
Brendon, run me through the five biggest injuries you've had.
Lacerated liver, bruised lung, broken ribs, torn knee ligaments, numerous concussions, which isn't anything to brag about, but anything you can possibly think of that could happen is going to happen in bull riding. And it's a game of inches, though. I mean, you see a lot of people get almost stood on, or something might happen to them. It looks like that something bad's going to happen, and they get up and walk away. Yeah. So it's part of our sport and part of what we have to put ourselves through to do.
You know, I love that phrase, it's a game of inches, because your entire careers come down to fractions, don't they?
Yeah.
For instance, you can't make any money. You don't stand a chance of doing anything else unless you get to the 8-second mark on a bull. How long is 8 seconds?
Well, it can feel like a long time sometimes. It's, you know, to think about 8 seconds, you really say it's not too long, but when you're on the back of a bull, it can seem like eternity sometimes. But you're right, unless we stay on for 8 seconds, we're not going to make any money. And then even though we do stay on for 8 seconds, we're not guaranteed to still make a living.
Because it's up to the other guys.
Yeah,
how long do they stay on for?
Well, it's a huge gamble, you know, because it's the bull, like he said, 50% of your score, so.
Yeah, you have almost reached the $1 million mark in earnings. How long is it going to take for you to get there?
Well, I'm hoping not too long. I mean, I'm not very far away from it.
Tamworth tomorrow, you could almost nail that.
I don't know if I can make enough there to do it, but I'll get real close. And, you know, I'd like to... I've set a goal by the end of January to do it, and I'll be the next bull rider in the sport to do it. So it's just it's up to me when I want to do it. If I stay on long enough on all of them, I'll do it.
Lachlan, and perhaps Brendon would know more about this, but I'm going to come to you because of your age. I would imagine the sport was good for the ladies. I'm thinking you're a bit of a party.
Look at him.
You wouldn't go to a party, you'd go to a shindig. You were at a bit of a shindig, you know, and you're standing in the corner of the room and a lady comes up to you and starts talking to you and says, what do you do for a living? And you say, I'm a professional bull rider. What's the reaction?
I don't really cop too much of that. Oh, you have to talk to Brendon about that one.
Look at him.
He's playing dark.
Yeah, he is. He's playing it down.
Do the okay, so just look at me and do the hat thing. Pretend I'm a fancy lady. Do you do the sort of madam?
No, I don't do that.
Ah, you don't. All right, I'm gonna have to come to you because you're the professional here. You've been doing it for so long, Brendon. Is it good for the ladies? Do you know what I mean?
Well, I think there's something about our sport that's fascinating to everybody, men or ladies, doesn't matter, kids, everyone, because it's something that not everybody, number one, wants to do, and number two, can do. So it's I think it's the fascinating thing about that, because usually when you show up somewhere and you may look like this, people will come up and they ask you what you do, and it surprises them more than anything.
All right, guys, thank you so much for coming, and all the very best at Tamworth tomorrow.
Thank
Take care, guys.
Yeah.
Take care.
Take care, absolutely.